We all have heard the saying that goes, love conquers all. But what if the one you love and trust is somebody you were always wrong about? Marriage is the purest bond between two people, and the husband and wife protect each other from all kinds of problems instead of being the cause of them. But Rebecca Logan has been a part of a marriage that will astonish you when you find out about it. After 7 years of being married to the same person, she discovers some very nasty surprises. Life has a lot in store for Rebecca, and while some of it will be devastating, some of it will be mesmerizing. Rebecca Logan is a hard-working woman who had finished her graduate school with a newborn, and just when she finished her school, she got the opportunity to start her dream career after working her way through nursing school. Rebecca had been married for 7 years, and she had a 3-year-old daughter. The family lived at a place Rebecca had always dreamed of. The house was in an adorable gated suburb, which was only 4 miles inland from Jacksonville Beach, Florida. I could cross Highway A1A at work and eat, sleep on the beach. My Jeep always had sand and seashells in it, said Rebecca, who had always been a beach person. What seemed to be a perfect life was soon going to get shattered and turned into a nightmare. Rebecca felt like she had achieved her dreams by landing the job as a pediatric nurse practitioner, a loving husband and daughter, and a lovely home. But it was all going to come crashing down very soon. Rebecca had always thought that she had found the love of her life, and it was a forever kind of bond between the two. But one Monday afternoon, all was going to change, and clearly, Rebecca was not prepared for any of it. Rebecca, her husband, and her little daughter celebrated Friday evening in a grand style, because it was their little princess's birthday. The lovely little girl had turned 3, and the theme of the party was luau, a traditional Hawaiian party. The daughter received a lot of presents on the occasion, but what followed next was unthinkable. Just 2 days after the birthday party, when Rebecca reached home from work, she was numb when she saw the scene outside her own house. All the presents received on Friday were crammed into a bin. Not just those, but every little thing that belonged to Rebecca was tossed out in the yard like it was all trash. When Rebecca tried going inside the house, she realized the locks of the house had been changed. I wasn't allowed back in our home, said Rebecca, who could not understand a single thing as to what was going on, was searching for her husband in hopes of a little support and calmness. When Rebecca asked for the reason of eviction from her own home, she found out that they were 3 months behind in the rent. She could not understand this at all, because she was a very responsible person and always gave money for rent on time to her husband. Rebecca had been giving out money to her husband for their living expenses from her own income. So where did all the rent money go? When she decided to confront her husband for the same, he was silent and did not even have a single word as an answer to Rebecca's questions. Rebecca felt hopeless. She could not understand what was going on and did not even know what to do next and whom to talk to. She said, "It was like I had been stabbed over and over, and I was moving too slow to stop the bleeding." Rebecca decided to take matters into her own hands when she sensed something fishy. Her husband had had erratic sleep habits for a long time now, and she had thought it was due to some work-related stress. He had even lost weight recently and was always running here or there for some work or the other and never wanted to take his wife and child along with him. When Rebecca started thinking deep, she noticed one thing which was mostly weird. Her husband never parked his car in the driveway. He always parked it in the guest parking spaces available in their neighborhood. She knew what she had to do next. She needed to search the car to find out what was going on. When Rebecca searched her husband's car, she found empty cans and pill bottles all scattered in the car. But there was something even bigger that was going to be the nightmare for Rebecca. This was just the beginning of the destruction of her life. I did some digging and found empty pill bottles and many empty beer cans in his car, Rebecca said. The wife found out that her husband had been hiding his substance abuse problem from her, all of which he hid in the same car in which he drove his own child to school. The pills were not the only horrifying thing that Rebecca was to come across. She decided to search further in the car that she was always kept away from. She searched under the seats and in the trunk of the car. As soon as she opened the trunk, she was taken aback by what she saw in front of her eyes. The trunk was full of several years of mail, all of which were addressed to Rebecca. Her own husband had been keeping letters from her that were from collection agencies, various bills, birthday cards, and a lot of other things. But why did he do this? Why had he been keeping so many secrets from his own family? Confused, hurt, and angry were my only emotions for the next few days. I was running on fumes and couldn't eat or sleep. I felt so stupid for not seeing the signs. I had been so busy with raising a child and building my practice at work. I was married to a drug addict, told Rebecca. But this was only the start of the list. The addiction, the stealing, the lying, as if all this was not enough that something even more hurtful was to follow in Rebecca and her little daughter's life. The picture was soon going to uncover itself, and the man Rebecca had married would suddenly be like someone she had never known. With tears in her eyes, Rebecca said, "He has been lying to me for years, and my credit was unfortunately ruined because of it. I had no idea how easy it was to open credit cards and take out personal loans in your spouse's name. I thought I had stayed on top of my bills, but had no idea he was secretly hiding things from me over the course of our 7-year marriage." On further investigation, Rebecca found out that he had not only lied about the money, but about his whole character. He lied about being in the Marine Corps. He lied about his education and his job. I had been living nothing but lies for almost a decade of my life. Rebecca felt like a fool who had been ignorant all through her married life about who her husband actually was. He had been taking undue advantage of her love for him and had been using her money for his own personal needs. But the most painful thing was yet to unfold itself. Rebecca's husband had been married to another woman, and not just that, he even had another daughter, and Rebecca was unaware of this. She said, "I thought to myself, how could life be so cruel? How could I be so dumb?" When Rebecca confronted her fraud husband, he abandoned her and their daughter without giving any clarifications or answers about anything. Rebecca and her daughter had been left alone in the middle of a crisis, but life had a very big and drastic change in store for them. After Rebecca realized that she and her daughter were on their own now, she became strong and came back to her senses. She rented a hotel room and straight away went into a supermarket to buy clothes and toiletries that would help them sustain for a few days till she could figure out something else. Rebecca was hurt, but she was trying hard to hide it all inside her and be happy. She said, "My daughter and I tried to make the best of our vacation, as I called it, while I cried over the things we had lost, wondering how in the world I would sort through this mess. My sweet baby girl lost everything and we had no support there." After much thought, Rebecca decided that the only feasible situation at the time would be to go back to her parents' house. She was heartbroken that at the age of 32, she would have to go back and live in her childhood bedroom along with her daughter. Rebecca said, "I left the beach and moved back to crummy old Tennessee. To make things worse, it was snowing when we moved back. It was March and snowing in Tennessee. How could this situation get any worse?" But that was the only place she could go with the kind of situation she was in. At nights, Rebecca would cry silently. She missed the life that she had built for herself with so much effort and affection, and she missed the part of her heart that she had loved her ex-husband with. But things were going to get beautiful very soon. After crying for days and blaming herself, Rebecca finally decided to move on and look at things positively. She put herself together and started working extensively to pay off the debts that her fraud husband had left in her name. While Rebecca was happy that her daughter was getting to spend quality time with her grandparents, she herself felt a little lonely and thought of catching up with old friends in town, and this decision of hers will change her life forever. Rebecca recalls, "I desperately needed to find some friends. I finally texted an old guy friend from high school. I jokingly asked if he knew any hot single dads. This wasn't even relevant in our conversation, just a random thought that popped in my head. To my surprise, he said yes and immediately gave me a name." After Rebecca had been betrayed so ruthlessly by her ex-husband, she was not sure if she was open for dating another guy so soon. She decided to search for the man whose name was Steven on Facebook and said, "My Facebook detective brain got to work. This single dad had a daughter who appeared to be the same age as mine." Rebecca showed her mother pictures of Steven and suddenly her mother shouted, "I know that little girl." in excitement when she saw Stephen's daughter's pictures. It turned out that Rebecca's mother's hairdresser was Stephen's ex-wife's sister, and she had pictures of the little girl in her salon. After such a coincidence, Rebecca's mom insisted that she should go and meet Stephen, and Rebecca agreed to it after much convincing because somewhere deep inside, she felt like maybe this coincidence was a sign of something magical to happen in her life. Rebecca had already searched for Stephen on Facebook, so she decided to send in a text on the same platform. And to Rebecca's surprise, Stephen replied right away. From that day onward, the two talked on texts and calls, and after a couple of them, they decided to meet each other. Even though Rebecca was a 32-year-old mother of one and had been married once, she felt nervous this time. It felt very different that she was going to meet someone new after so long and after passing through such a hard time that she could not contain her nervousness. After spending the whole night wondering what it would be like to meet Stephen, the day finally arrived and the two single parents met each other. And Rebecca's experience was, "I had the biggest grin all day and I was smitten. I could not stop thinking about him." But Rebecca did not want to keep herself in a fake light and make herself happy. "After all, I was just damaged goods. With my awful credit and all the baggage I had, surely this guy would just move on and there was no reason to get my hopes up," she said. Even though Rebecca was skeptical about Stephen, God had other plans for the two. Stephen was equally smitten with Rebecca as she was with him. Days passed by and the two secretly loved each other, but Rebecca was scared to say anything because she did not want Stephen to run away from her life. Since Rebecca had been betrayed once, she was finding it very hard to trust Stephen. To bring her out of the traumatic experience that she had faced, Stephen did all that he could. He showed her his bank statements, credit scores, up-to-date mortgage payments, and all that was required to help Rebecca regain the trust. Stephen put all his energy and affection on letting Rebecca come out of the traumatizing experience and fall in love with him freely. She was glad she had him and said, "I was slowly letting him into my heart and he was helping me rebuild piece by piece. I certainly didn't need to be saved by anyone, but he swooped in and saved me." Rebecca and Stephen spent as much time together as they could, and soon the two became inseparable. Not only the two of them, but even their daughters had become best friends and spent all day together, and soon Rebecca's life was going to change. Stephen went down on his knees and proposed to Rebecca. He wanted her to be his forever. Rebecca, on the other hand, was also sure about what she had to do. She said, "At that moment, I knew my intent to move out of Tennessee just wasn't part of the plan right now. Something brought me back home, and love was going to keep me there." In a small and intimate ceremony on the 15th of August, the two lovers said yes to each other and became a happy, loving family. From suffering intensely, Rebecca did find love where she least expected to, and Stephen and Rebecca moved in together in a small house. After being married for some time, Rebecca and Stephen moved into a bigger house and stayed happily with their two daughters. They were and are still determined to beat the odds of meeting so abruptly and having such a short courtship period. The couple is aware that people will question their relationship if they know the details. Rebecca says, "People are always curious to hear our story, so we just look at each other and smile. Usually our story goes, we met on a blind date and got married 4 months later. In the end, love wins." And soon enough, when Rebecca was 35 years old in 2017, they welcomed a new member of their family. They had a child, and it was yet again a beautiful daughter. The couple started off from a blank canvas and had slowly but steadily painted it with love. People always talk negatively about Rebecca and Stephen's wedding, that it was doomed. Both of them have extremely stressful jobs, and it does become quite hectic some days. But the two are adamant about proving everybody wrong together. Both Rebecca and Stephen are fighting their battles with the exes. The drama has not ended yet, and both are trying to fight for the custody of their little princesses. But none of them is willing to give up, and will do all that they can to win every battle that comes their way.